Hi, welcome to ANSYS tutorial for nonlinear analysis of deep reinforced concrete beam using ANSYS Workbench 2019. The workflow demonstrated in this tutorial is intended for practical purposes rather than research purposes. This tutorial will show how to make a fast model for nonlinear analysis of reinforced concrete elements while sacrificing some accuracy in comparison with the workflow that's specifically intended for research, which takes much more time. The input data in this tutorial will follow the load test report of reinforced concrete deep beam. The details of the load test report could be found in the description below. The input data is taken from beam number 12. The geometry of concrete beam, impactor, and reinforcement, have been prepared in Autodesk Revit, which offer much faster modeling than built-in ANSYS SpaceClaim. The import geometry could also be found in the description below. The stress-strain curve for rebars using the simple bilinear model. The stress-strain curve for concrete using the nonlinear curve following this formula. The maximum concrete strain shall be limited at 0.003. In this workflow, limiting the maximum compressive strain in concrete is better than using crushing strength. The element type for the concrete model is solid 65. Although solid 65 is the old legacy element, it is still the best option for fast modeling with acceptable accuracy for real-life structural engineering problems. ANSYS Workbench does not directly support the solid 65 element. APDL command is required in order to access the solid 65 element. The APDL commands are included in the description below. Please note that this workflow does not support cracking and crushing plots. Concrete and rebars will be tied together with constraint equation. Constraint equation is not suitable for very large displacement. Always choose the conventional merge nodes method whenever dealing with large deformation problems and never ever use constraint equation with a large deformation problem. Fortunately, most of the structural engineering problems, especially reinforced concrete members, are not categorized as large deformation because the serviceability limit state will govern the design before structural deformation becoming large. Finally, the analysis results will be compared with the load test results. The advantage of the workflow presented in this tutorial is that it is much faster than conventional modeling while the losing accuracy is still within the acceptable practical range. Without further ado, let's begin the tutorial.